Aries, this is your channel.
No.
I'm so used to doing channel messages. This is your pick a card reading for the 25th of November. I am your host, Vanessa Carby. Aries, I have a channel message for you and then I have a short song, okay? So Aries, your channel message is, in case you didn't know, sex consummates the relationship, union, or marriage. This is why we always say, wait until marriage to have sex, Aries, okay? Make a thing, you're going to be with a guy, the guy not going to want to have sex with you. If it's a girl, she will not want to have sex with you. She only believe in having sex to consummate the relationship. Which to a man means she not here until you decide to call her your girlfriend. Okay? But also, is the act of consummating a union. Yes, you're out with somebody, you're friends with them, you go out on dates. Can you do activities without having sexual pleasures? If you cannot, then it's lust, it's not love. If you can be around somebody the whole day, hang out with them, to own and do mutual things together, and you never had to have sex, that is the person you're supposed to spend your life with, okay? So I'm getting, the next time you feel like, okay, I want to plan this big moment, and then we're going to have sex, and then after we have sex, I'm going to say, you know what, I want you to be my girlfriend. No, I'm getting to ask a person to be your girlfriend or boyfriend first, and then after the start date, the first time, I'm going to be like a honeymoon. I'm getting you want the first time with this person to be very prepared, very magical, but I'm getting you, we really want to take a time with this one, okay? So, with that being said, this is your message, channel song, Aries.
Time is going by so much faster than I'm starting to regret not spending all of it with you. Now I'm wondering why I've kept this bottle inside, and I'm starting to regret not telling all of it to you. So if I ever get out, I'll let you know you're never gonna be alone from this moment on. And if you ever feel like letting go, I won't let you fall. When all hope is gone, I'll hold you till we carry on. And now, as long as I can, I'm holding on with both hands. Cause I forever believe that there's nothing I need but you. So if I haven't yet, I gotta let you know you're never gonna be alone from this moment on. And if you ever feel like letting go, I won't let you fall.
Aries.
When all hope is gone, I know that you can carry on. And when
I'm older than I'm starting to get older and die.
I'm starting to regret not spending some of my time with you.
Aries, I want you to know that you're never gonna be alone. Aries, even though you're the first, okay, even though you always try to figure out things on your own, I'm getting, Aries, you don't have to be alone. And I'm getting, once this union comes into play, you'll never be alone. Never, not as a friend, not as a lover, not as a husband or wife, you'll never be alone. You'll never feel alone, Aries, okay? So let's go ahead and go into your pick a card reading. Okay, I'm going to switch this because you saw it. Did you see that? I'm going to switch that. You saw that. There you go. Okay, Aries, choose your card. If this is card number one that you have selected, Aries, then I am getting the Four of Wands. So I'm getting moving in at Aries or relocating. All right. I'm getting a beautiful building, beautiful people. I'm getting a relocate, Aries, which is great news. We have a sun card. Yeah, you're very, very happy. Now you could be relocating because you're pregnant, you need a bigger space. But if that's not it, I'm getting you relocating. The place is beautiful. You're going to be so happy there. There may be kids on the vicinity. I'm getting something about kids. All right. You're the Three of Swords though. Oh no. Maybe this is something that's supposed to hurt you. You're going to be moving in a building and you're going to see everybody with kids and you're the only person there who don't have a kid. Sweetie, you know that alien, you know that later on in life when, because the aliens already invaded Earth already. So later on in life when them explain what they want to explain to Ono, them going to tell you, yeah, you guys never even had to repopulate. You know that? You fuck up your body and you don't live 100 years when you do. Actually, yeah, some people really live 100 years after them repopulated. Other than that, yeah, we don't need to repopulate. We don't need to cut into flesh and skin. That's not, excuse me, no, sweetie, I'm sorry. That is so before the aliens came to Earth. You see, we had to tell you something for keep you as slaves. How do you keep someone as slave? You make them take care of a baby. Just like how the slave plantation owners used to make the black slaves take care of the babies, right? That's how you make somebody a slave and then you provide them with emotional attachment. Thus you had babies. You see, if you do anything to yourself, you'll get the repercussions of it. Whether you hurt yourself, you have sex without protection and you'll get pregnant. That's okay. But unfortunately, I'm so sorry that you learn later in life. You never even had to have kids. You know that? That was a distraction for all I know. For never achieve your dreams, for never reach your full potential in life, for never open your third eye, for always be distracted in the matrix. You have kids. Once you have kids, you're gone. Even if it is enlightened, you're gone right back down. Because you have took in a part of yourself, you photocopy it, and now you have to relearn yourself, which is a child, while telling a child the things that you had to unlearn. You get me? So yeah. So maybe this is going to be heartbreaking, sweetie, can adopt. I don't know why you are pumping your fucking stomach with fucking, what you call it? You know the things I'm gonna get like drinking on them blood clot side and I'm just stuff on them side with the fucking hormone shit to get pregnant? Adopt. You never know, so we weren't supposed to have kids. That's why Adam and Eve never had kids in the Garden of Eden. The next card out is the Strength card. So I'm getting a Leo. Something about a Leo. Me getting the babies a Leo. Something about a Leo baby. Maybe somebody want you to see it. I don't know, somebody's using a baby and rubber in front of you. Somebody use a baby for spite, yo. Sweetie, you shouldn't use a baby and spite me. Where's the man? There we go. We have the Hierophant. Yeah, where the man there? You can't spite me with baby. You have to spite me with a marriage. You have to show me how much the man are sending in your account every week. You have to show me what the man are buy you. Show me all the times the man give you one foot rub, ass rub, and breast rub. That's what you need to show me. You have to tell me about baby. Anybody can get baby. If we want to, if they say, you know what, I'm going to get pregnant today, come and tell you this 311. I'm going to get pregnant and have pregnancy assistance. I can't go up on Tinder now and meet a guy. I can't fuck him tonight and make him come in me tonight. It's not that hard. And half of them, very, very commendable. Them just never really been around women. So that's why them penis is out of control, right? So I'm going to get a nice, not I could have gotten a fucking Iranian baby. Half Iranian, half fucking Jamaican, right? You can't rub baby in your face. They have to rub the marriage with the commitment there. Because this is hard to get. The baby easy to get. This is what's hard to get. And even when you get this, I have the baby, him up on you. So I don't know what this is. Yeah, the Hierophant again. Hierophant, this is what we want. This is what the aliens will tell you about. All they need is two people for commit. You can adopt the baby. You want the baby to be a Taurus, you can adopt a Taurus, a Leo, a Sagittarius, or an Aries. We were not supposed to have kids. Adam and Eve never had kids in the Garden of Eden for a reason. Because everybody know when you have a kid, your kid take on the karma what you do. Your kid don't born innocent. Your kid is born innocent in the eyes of God, but your kid is not born innocent in the eyes of society. If your parents had a debt, then I'll put the debt on your kid. If your parents did fuck up things and broke promises or the weird ass things when you were a baby, when you grow up, you're gonna get targeted. In the Garden of Eden, they never had kids. What we will learn soon enough, those who have a high IQ, because we still need Earth to repopulate. We still need slaves to believe that they're making a contribution to Earth. We still need people to believe that climate change is actually a thing. Right? Okay, great. Two Hierophants here. You can't hype with me with baby, sweetie. That baby just stretch out your vagina, you have stretch marks now, and we don't know how your breast going to look after you start breastfeeding. You have to hype on me with your man. Show me what your man do for you. Show me how much money you give a week time. Show me the text messages. Good morning, baby. I miss you so much. Show me that. Show me the commitment you can get. Because baby, easy to get, sweetie. So again,
you're never gonna be alone from this moment on.
Right? Some people don't want to be alone, so they run to have a baby with a man who don't want them. What you're supposed to do is find somebody who wants to be beside you.
You're never gonna be alone to this oath I take. You're never gonna be alone from this moment on.
And if you ever feel like letting go, Taurus, even though we're doing Aries, if you ever feel like letting go, I will never make you fall. As long as you tell me. The Hierophant two time. Alright. Okay, great. So going to your second reading. Choose your second card, Aries. If this is the card you selected, Aries, then you have selected the Temperance. I'm getting a Sagittarius energy, alright? I'm getting something that's very content. I'm getting calmness, stillness, silence. We have the Eight of Swords. Maybe that's why there's calmness, stillness, and silence. You have to be getting your weight on universal guidance for your next move. You don't know where you are. You can't see, you can't hear, you can't move. You don't know what to do, but you know if you wait on guidance, guidance will tell you what to do at the right time. Now, I'm not exactly sure why the angel is in captivity, okay? We have the Page of Cups. Me getting you feel bad about your son or about this water sign boy. You can't help him. Me getting him need your help and you can't help him. I don't know if you're stuck or you just don't have the resources for help. But me getting somebody is like calling out for your help and you can't help them. You can't get there. You don't have money to help them. You can't. Me getting you stuck. You feel so stuck because you can't help your son. You're the hangman. You feel like your son going to hate you. Him going to see you as a bad parent. Your son could be a Scorpio Sagittarius. I'm getting you think about this Page of Cups so much. Yeah, you think about them so much. Me don't know if your son in prison, your son... Maybe your son passed. Me getting your son to watch over you. Me getting ever since your son passed, you're crippled. Mentally, physically, emotionally. But me getting your son to watch over you. Your son is okay. Me getting you can't accept the fact that your son gone. Maybe your son passed. Because me getting something... Maybe you're a harsh parent to your son. And you were just trying to be a strict parent. You weren't trying to like make your son hate you. But when getting something happened to your son, I don't know if your son attempting suicide. You have a Ten of Cups. Yeah, something in the family breakdown. Something happened with the family. I'm getting is the mother. Something going on with the mother. The son is lashing out because of the mother. The son is lashing out because of what's happening to the mom. Me getting the mom stuck, the mom vulnerable, or the mom can't do much, and the son wants a mother and him lashing out. He might be lashing out at the dad. If the son is with a dad and girl, or he's with his mother and stepdad, he might lash out on family because he wants a mother. The last card is Five of Cups. Or I'm getting your son is still sour about the fact that you're leaving mother and you're with a new woman. And you expect him to come over this house, accept this new woman as him, and hear this woman talking shit about his mother. He don't like her. Just because you want to push your penis in that, it don't mean your son have to... Your son don't have to suffer just because you want it to. All right, so your final card, Aries, is the Queen of Cups. So I'm getting you're dealing with a Cancer, Pisces, or Scorpio, Aries. All right, so I'm getting you reanalyzing your feelings, your emotions, or you're reanalyzing maybe what you want to do in life. We have the Three of Wands. It could be the direction in life. I'm getting you wondering if you should relocate or at least take 3 months somewhere else. We have the Queen of Swords. We get to get one, visit your sister. We have Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio here. Then we have Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. You want to... I'm getting the Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio is writing the Gemini, Libra, Aquarius a letter. Okay? They're going to send you a letter or send you a message. The Four of Wands. Them want you to come visit them. It might be overseas. somebody saying, hey, I just got a place, I just got an apartment, I settled now, come visit me. I'm getting the water sign is asking the air sign to do this. The King of Cups. Okay, so I'm getting the Queen of Cups, King of Cups. This is a couple. I'm getting she live with a man. I'm getting a water sign woman, a water sign man, which are usually counterparts. I'm getting the man living at the house. I don't know if the woman lives in the house or she planning to relocate. Me getting the girl where you're inviting her to the house, to stay in the house with you and your man. Your man a plan to make she stay in the house. He not plan to make you stay in there. So maybe you ask somebody, ex-boyfriend, ex-husband for help. Come getting you and the man don't, you, the water signs, them don't talk to each other. But he's closer to the house. Unless this is a woman, she's messaging her ex-boyfriend's girlfriend about something. The Nine of Cups, and we have the Five of Pentacles. Yeah, me getting a need somewhere for stay. So you and this man used to be together. Me getting you not together anymore. The man of a place. I don't know how desperate this is. Cause me get, I am getting that the man here want two women in the house. You hear? Anything him said, don't believe him. The man here in his house, okay? He knows, cause he did this to you. Him know you're not nowhere for go. Him I got offer you for come stay with him. But if I go tell you, say him and his wife is estranged, him and his wife don't talk, or him and his wife is, he might, his wife might be in another country, he be in a country, might tell you to come stay with him. I don't know where his wife there, but he might tell you for moving with him and him have a wife. I don't know if his wife at the time, I don't know if his wife gone go see her mother, she gone to her auntie, she gone to her uncle, but me getting the wife gone where, and this man I tell you, yeah man, come move in with me, move in. But apparently, you might move in and spend money, then they might kick you out when the wife comes back. And you can show the wife, look what I did for this house. I was waiting on you. No, bitch, you had a whole woman in the house, moved in the house, living, sleeping in the same spot. You know, wife have a blood clot sleep on. I don't know where she was. Where was she? Come and getting your stage a whole relationship moving with a woman, kick out the woman, and I know the wife never even find out about this. Cause her she don't know where she there. She must have visited her mother. Yeah. Woo. Crazy business. No. We have enemy. We have program. Or I'm getting you left and you want to go back to your man. I'm getting you can't go back to him because unbeknownst to you, your friend, your sister, or I'm getting him living with another woman. He don't want to tell you that though, but he's living with another woman. It doesn't it hurt when the man who you left but still forgave that cheated on you start a cheat on him ex-woman with you. When I was with him, you took him from me. When I was with him, you couldn't stop text off him phone. Now me divorce him, gal. I'm going to rekindle the romance. I'm going to make him feel like the first time he went down on his knees and proposed to me. That's what I'm going to make him feel like, you fucker, yo. You decide to mash up my shit when I was with him. No problem, sweetie. I just wait for him to get, me wait for him to be committable, settle down, and say to himself, you know what, this is who I'm going to spend my life with. Gotcha, bitch, you have an ex-wife. And believe me, I am not the bitter ex-wife. I'm the ex-wife who knows that you're not going to find a girl who looks better than me. Ask any man I ever date, ask him if their new girlfriend looks better than me. Regardless of race, regardless of education, regardless of if them have two parents or one, regardless if they use DGC or not, right? Any man me ever date, any girl me see them with after me, they did not look better than me. They didn't. It's either them downgrade or me don't know what kind of grade them was grading. Any man me have ever dated in my life, whether I date with them or me date them, usually they don't move on to better looking than me. Never. And them don't move on to as intelligent as me. Them always go lower. Because once you meet me, you're like, oh, maybe I don't want an intelligent girl because she know a lot. So where is our kid? I'm so excited to meet my non-existent kid. Where is he? You fuck up my marriage, you're going to fuck up your relationship after my marriage. We have Vision. We have Gemini. Hi, Gemini. Yep, are you? Gemini, who is this? We have Debt. Hi. One more. I'm a got bright future. The future must be bright. Believe me, he may not have been my husband, but he's going to be the man who's f***ing on you with me. How much you bet me? How much you Claude bet me? Bet me like how you didn't bet me, say, Vibes Cartel now come out of prison. There you go. I'm going to leave it here. 2 bags of sugar. Until next time. Bye.
Oh my God.